Yo, what is going on, guys? My name is Adigo, and today I'm going to show you guys how to rotate the control rotation to focus on a certain object or a vector. So in other words, we're going to make the player camera focus on this box. You can also do this with an enemy, for example, so with another blueprint, but in this case we're just going to focus on the vector of this box. So what we want to do is I'm going to create a trigger, and if you walk over that, it will happen basically. So we're going to create a blueprint actor, and we're gonna call it rotation underscore actor, and then we will drag it right here. We will add box collision and we will resize this in the level. So then we want to scroll down and on component begin overlap, then the other actor is, in this case, it's gonna be the third person character. Then we want to do a do once. We want to add this just to be sure that we don't walk over it a second time and it keeps going longer than 5 seconds. You can do whatever you want, but I'm just going to add that in this case. And the next thing we want to do is add a timeline. Just call it timeline, doesn't really matter. And in this case, we will just do 5 seconds. Let's add a flow track. Let's add a key, set the time to 0, add another key and set the time to the end, which is 5 in this case. And the value doesn't really matter because we're not going to use that. Right, so we want to get the actor location from the player character, and we want to get control rotation from the player character as well. And then from the actor location, we want to find get rotation. Then in this case, we're going to use the vector from that box, but you can also use the vector from another character. So if you want to do that, you can just cast to that character here and use that factor, just plug it in there. But in this case, we're gonna split the struct pin, and we're going to copy the factor real quick, paste it in here. So that will be the location we focus on, the factor of this box. So then the next thing we wanna do is we wanna reinterp 2. And then the current is actually the control rotation. That is actually the current control rotation, right? And the target is going to be the look at rotation, like that. So the next thing we want to do is we want to get player controller, right? And from the player controller, we want to set control rotation. Set control rotation, and new rotation is the rotation that's coming out of the reinsert 2. Then we want to update from the timeline, so every time the timeline will update, it will call this set control rotation. And then the only two things we have left to do is we have to get the delta time, so that is get world delta seconds right here. And the interrupt speed, we can just set that to, let's just set it to 2 in this case. And if we go into the map right now and we get this trigger, place it like this. So if I walk into it, as you can see, the camera will focus on the cube, on the factor. So if I do that again, if I keep walking, as you can see, the camera also decides where the player is going to walk, if you know what I'm trying to say. So as you can see, if it's rotating, the player will rotate around the cube as well, which is perfect for if you want to use something like this in your game. If you want to focus on a certain boss or a certain door that's opening, or you know, whatever you want to do, you can use that. So you can, in this case, it's a trigger. You can obviously call this event on you can do whatever, but in this case I just use a trigger. But obviously you can do whatever. So I hope you guys enjoyed this simple video, and I'll see you guys later.